being few and far between and airtime relatively limited. It's really grown up around the so-called sound system, which is a souped-up mobile disco that plays in clubs, dance halls, or even people's front rooms. In fact, sound system DJs were amongst the first people to make reggae records. If a DJ wanted to have a hit that you could only hear on his personal sound system, he would hire a studio and musicians to record something for his own exclusive use and press the records on his own label so you could only hear it if you went along to his gigs. In the studio, we have one of London's most popular.
Walking around the clock. In this club, find the silence of the night. Rapper. Rock and soul. Cheer up. I tell rock, I tell sounds.
Hold it. Hello, Fat Man.
Hi, Jane.
Now, what's this guy doing?
He's giving them a touch of the roots, you know?
Yeah? Now, what's your name, sorry?
Well, let me check out as Aroy.
Okay, Aroy, what are you doing exactly?
Well, actually, I'm just talking on the music to make people feel higher, you know?
Yeah, and what's it called?
Well, it's toasting.
It's called toasting.
Yeah.
And you make up different words for every record.
Yeah, as you go along, you know.
Yeah, what sort of things do you say?
Well, you get the feeling, you just make them enjoy, you say, yeah. Love is lovely, I tell song, which means jungle fresh music, you know.
Yeah.
And dub music, which is dub wise music, you know.
Yeah, so you just help them to enjoy the record,
yeah,
better.
You know?
Great. Now, Fat Man's going to play us some of the different kinds of reggae from the past 15 years or so, and he's brought along some dancers to show us the dances that go with them. Isn't it?
Yes, it's a number called The Guns of Navarone by a group of musicians who dominated the ska era from the late 50s right through to the beginning of Rocksteady in 1965. They're called the Scatterlites and were all proficient musicians with a jazz training. Artists like Roland Alfonso on sax, Don Drummond on trombone, and as well as making their own records, they backed almost every major act from Jamaica during this period.
In the early 60s, Jamaican immigrants brought reggae over here, and in England it was almost exclusively handled by two companies, Island and Melodisc. Melodisc's label was called Bluebeat, and that's what the English fans called ska. It became a brief craze amongst mods like myself and Jamaicans living in England, and in the early 60s, Jimmy Cliff arrived in England to cash in on the boom. Millie Small took My Boy Lollipop to the top of the charts in 1964, and for a while it looked as if reggae had really arrived.
The important thing about ska was the wild honking horn arrangement and the insistent beat the dance they did too. It was the ska, note the hands and hip movements. For some reason that cannot be explained, during the middle of the 60s, the music began to be slowed down. This was the era known as Rocksteady, and that's the title of this song by Alton Ellis, one of the best-known artists of the period, along with Ken Booth, Roy Shirley, the Heptones, and so on. With the slower music, the accent of the dance became a coordination of shoulder and leg movements. In the music, the horns had become less popular and the rhythms were starting to become from the bass guitar.
Because the beat was slower and more difficult to dance to, white kids didn't go for rocksteady the same way as they had for ska. Reggae went back to being a minority music.
In 68, the Maytals came up with the first recorded song that used the word reggae. It was called Do the Reggae. The beat was much faster. Notice the importance of the driving rhythm guitar in keeping it going. The dance is now totally self-expressive, involving the whole body. This is the beginning of reggae as we know it today.
Do the dance. Do the dance. Some working class kids again turned briefly to reggae in the late 60s and early 70s when the skinheads found it was really good to dance to.